Trump sends fear down spines of lawmakers who paid to have sexual harassment claims silence. Since the day he took office, President Donald Trump has been making lawmakers on both sides of the aisle uncomfortable with his drain-the-swamp mentality that has upset Washington's traditional, cozy way of doing business. But Trump's announcement response to questions from reporters Tuesday as he was leaving the White House to spend the Thanksgiving holiday at his Mar-a-Lago resort must have had some feeling more than uncomfortable. A bolt of fear down their spine might be more like it. That's because Trump came out loud and clear in support of the idea that lawmakers who have paid settlements to sexual harassment accusers should be identified to the public. "I do, I really do," Trump said in a brief news conference on the South Lawn, according to the UK Daily Mail. Considering that the Democratic Party is currently being racked by sexual harassment scandals, from Al Franken in the Senate and the iconic John Conyers in the House to the Democrat bastions in Hollywood, that's a prospect that can't be very palatable to the supposed party of women's empowerment. But it's a prospect that's been fostered by one of its own, California Representative Jackie Speier, who last week revealed that the House of Representatives had paid out $15 million in the two decades between 1997 and 2016, according to The Hill. Granted, not all of those settlements necessarily involved sexual harassment. The figure from the U.S. Congress Office of Compliance also covers racial and religious discrimination, as well as discrimination against people with disabilities, The Hill reported. But it's safe to say a fair number of them did involve sexual harassment. And if the current climate is any guide, it's even safer to bet that there were Democrats involved. This is the party, after all, that portrays itself as the champion of women, but has lately been caught with two of its more liberal figures being outed as abusing their office, or even their constituents, for their own gratification. The most recent, of course, is Michigan Democrat John Conyers, the fabled co-founder of the Congressional Black Caucus, who's now caught up in a very public scandal involving a pattern of making unwanted sexual advances to subordinates. The case of one woman alone resulted in Conyers' office shelling out more than $27,000 in public funds to pay for a no-show job that allowed the woman to collect a salary for 3 months in return for her silence. The case of Franken, Minnesota's junior senator, has been public for a week now with the accusation that Franken groped a woman during a USO trip in 2006, an accusation with a picture to back it up. But it has gotten worse, with the revelation that a one-time constituent has accused him of groping her briefly during picture-taking moment at the Minnesota State Fair in 2010. These are documented scandals, remember, with paperwork and photographs, unlike the hazy, decades-old accusations against Roy Moore, the Republican Senate candidate in Alabama. Now, Democrats have an annoying tendency to preen as though they're the only Americans who care about justice and equality for women. But the history of the party for at least a generation, since Bill Clinton's hedonistic heyday in the White House, has been exactly the opposite. But regardless of party, the current public attention on matters pertaining to sexual misbehavior, Trump's full-throated embrace of the idea that the lawmakers involved in taxpayer dollars being spent to compensate the victims of sexual harassment on Capitol Hill has to make some lawmakers very uncomfortable indeed. And if they're guilty, a little fear down their spine might be just what the doctor ordered. Share this story on Facebook and Twitter if you're glad President Trump spoke out about this issue. What do you think will come of complaints about sexual harassment on Capitol Hill? Scroll down to comment below.